Good morning, and welcome to Let's Talk Real Estate on 101.5 Sports Radio Lakes Region. Today's show is presented by the Cisneros Realty Group, powered by EXP Realty, and sponsored by Dana Gunnarsson, agent at the Joe Suazo Allstate Insurance Office, Hudkins Law, Title, and Settlement, and NCT, Nano Coating Technologies. It's time to join our host at Let's Talk Real Estate.
And good Saturday morning. My name is Karina Cisneros, realtor with the Cisneros Realty Group, powered by EXP Realty. We cover the New Hampshire Lakes region from Concord to Franconia. Our show focuses on all aspects of real estate, and in the next 30 minutes, we'll share with you important information that will help you with either buying or selling your home. Today, a very special guest, Sue Waters, realtor with the Cisneros Realty Group here in Guilford, New Hampshire. Welcome, Sue.
Good morning, Karina.
Good morning. I thought it would be very appropriate to have Sue on our show today because aside from being a very lovely lady and realtor, Sue is extremely knowledgeable about what we know today as Airbnb and VRBO. So Sue, first of all, what does VRBO stand for?
Vacation Rental by Owner.
Okay, cool. I didn't know that. All right, so those are the two main ones that are out there, right?
Yes.
Okay.
They're the popular ones.
Okay, good. Now, how many properties do you own currently that are being rented through Airbnb?
Karina, I have two properties, one located in Bartlett at the base of Attitash Mountain, and the other is in Lincoln, located by Loon Mountain.
And how long have you been renting them?
I've been doing this for 4 years.
All right, so that really qualifies you to talk about this subject. And this is the reason why you're on the show today. Okay, because we want to help and educate our audience about what it's really like to own a piece of property and put it on these rental sites.
Well, it's an interesting experience. It does require some work. It's a lot of fun, and it's a great way to supplement your income.
All right, let's talk a little bit about that. So let's say you, as a realtor, get a call from somebody, Sue, I want to buy a property, but I also want some supplemental income, and I want to make sure it's the right property to rent on either one of these two sites. What would be the two or three or four things that you would want them to know?
I think it's important that they know the location and they have a knowledgeable person to help them realize what the area has to offer. And then it's also becoming very important to be aware of the city or town ordinances and laws that govern short-term rentals.
Okay.
That's really coming into play here.
Let's drill down a little bit more. What is the ideal property in terms of bedrooms, condo, single family, in your experience up here in the New Hampshire Lakes region and mountains?
Location is key. You want to have a place that people, vacation tourists, want to come to.
Give us some examples, please.
A ski mountain, a lake area, a beachfront, or you could have something that's just unique, a treehouse, a home with a beautiful waterfall. It has to be something that attracts vacation rentals.
Okay. Is it better to have two bedrooms, three bedrooms, four bedrooms? What is that? Why is that important?
Well, it's been my experience. I have studios, and I find that they bring a good income. Of course, you can get more if you have a bigger place, but it's not necessarily a lot more. So you can do a lot with a small space.
Okay, very interesting. So we talked about the type of property, location. What about amenities?
Amenities are important. You have to have a property that people want to come to, and they can be something simple as a pool or just a beautiful area to visit.
Can you please explain to us, Sue, a little bit more on the zoning regulations?
They're coming into play, Karina, because neighbors are complaining and the towns are stepping up to make sure that the property owners are responsible for their guests. The cities and towns are stepping up as neighbors have come forward to complain about noise, disruptive guests. So it's becoming very important for property owners to manage their guests well, to know who they're renting to, and to understand what the restrictions and laws are in the town.
All right, Sue, hold your next thought. You are listening to Let's Talk Real Estate on 101.5 Sports Radio Lakes Region.
Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays. For no matter how far away you roam, when you long for the sunshine of a friendly gaze, for the holidays you can't be.
This is Let's Talk Real Estate with Karina Cisneros on 101.5 WEEI Sports Radio Lakes Region. Once again, here's Karina.
And we are back with Sue Waters, realtor with the Cisneros Realty Group. She is an expert on short-term rentals through Airbnb. She owns two properties and has been renting them for the past 4 years. Okay, Sue, let's get down to a couple more topics on this. What are the fees? What does it cost? How much money is really can you really realistically make by going through this process of listing it on the internet, doing reservations, doing deposits, and switching the units from one tenant to another? Just tell us what the process is, what the cycle is.
Well, Karina, they can be time intensive if you want to do a good job with this. However, the rewards are plenty. There's a lot of people that are doing Airbnb and VRBO just as guests. There's a lot of people doing that. So some of the things to think about are who is going to help you clean the property, who is going to help you care for the grounds or the home. So these factors can come into a decision when a person is purchasing a property. Is it someplace that's close for them to do this themselves? Do they have to hire out the work? Do they want a condo where they don't have maintenance? All of these factors come into play.
Okay. What about the fees and costs?
The fees and costs can vary. Airbnb is currently at 3% and VRBO is at 5%. However, there are other things that factor into an owner's cost, so that needs to be kept in mind. But you can purchase an annual package where you're not paid per transaction for VRBO, for example. So there is a little bit of a science there, figuring out what you want to make and what can be profitable for you, but that's adjustable.
All right, so can you just go through a cycle with us? They come onto the website and they make a deposit. I mean, how's that work?
So generally what happens is they come to the website and they will put in an inquiry and I will begin to form a relationship with them, find out what they're looking for and what they're hoping to do on their vacation. And then the deposit is put in. Airbnb keeps that. I don't see that until they check out. Then we set up when they will come. We make an arrangement for them to check in, whether it's me going there to meet them or having a lockbox that they can let themselves in. They come, they have their visit. I'm usually available if they need help with anything. And then they check out. I clean or I find someone to clean. And they leave a review of the property. And payment is made after that.
So what would be the one hardest thing or the challenge for doing Airbnb if you're the owner of the unit?
Some of the challenges that I don't think people think about is that guests have questions and they have the expectation that you're going to be able to help them if necessary. And that can sometimes be challenging if you have other jobs or life and you need to be able to help them when they reach out.
Okay, so and what would be the one or two things that are absolutely amazingly great and delightful to be an owner of an Airbnb property?
You meet people from all around the world. People truly appreciate when you open your home to them if you choose the right guests carefully. And
how do you choose the right guests carefully, by the way?
It's important to have an interaction with them and really take some time to find out who they are, what they're looking to do, and what they expect from your property. That dialogue needs to happen for both parties to be satisfied.
So what do you think would happen if that wouldn't happen like that?
You have to be able to scrutinize who's coming to your property because it's your investment and you want it to be the right property for them so that they're happy too. So it's a benefit for everybody to put time in the beginning to get to know your guests.
So one of the couple things that I may be apprehensive about if I am if I'm the owner of a property and I'm putting it on Airbnb is somebody takes something that doesn't belong to them, or if there's damage to an expensive damage to a piece of furniture or something, how is that handled?
Airbnb and VRBO both have damage deposit and policies. However, I feel personally that the most important thing you can do is once again develop a relationship with the person that's coming, and you'll be amazed at how you can gauge if they're unresponsive. They may be irresponsible. If they're appreciative and they communicate well with you, 99% of the time it goes well.
Okay. All right. So that's quite interesting. What else? So tell us some anecdotes. The good, bad, and the ugly. Just maybe something happened that was unexpected, that was special. Maybe something happened that was really bad news. Just share with us some experiences that you've had in the past from you or some of your colleagues.
The good, the bad, and the ugly. The good can be people that are from out of the country that leave you little notions of appreciation. I've gotten some amazing drawings and little pieces of art that they create while they're there, which is fun. It's a treasure. The bad is when things don't go exactly as you hoped, maybe a snowstorm or a key card doesn't work. It could be something unexpected like that. The ugly, I read about the ugly on the internet, but knock on wood, because I take so much care with knowing the people, trying to know the people, I have not experienced much ugly yet.
Oh, that's good. That's really good. Okay, so just to recap, if you're thinking about putting your property on Airbnb, you already have one, well, that's kind of pretty simple. You do your own research and you put it on Airbnb. But if you don't have a property yet, of course, and you're struggling to understand what would be a great location or what kind of property and what kind of amenities, and if the town or area is welcoming to short-term leases through Airbnb, my best piece of advice is call your favorite realtor. Find a realtor that understands these things, preferably a realtor who is doing it or has done it. And of course, I've just introduced you to one of the best that I know, which is Sue Waters, who happens to be my partner at the Cisneros Realty Group here in Guilford, New Hampshire. Sue, if anybody in our audience wants to reach out to you, how can they do that?
They can call me
at
603-651-9696. a little bit of a warning. I love to talk about Airbnb. So they need to leave themselves plenty of time.
Are you currently working with any clients that are looking to do this?
I am, actually, and okay. We're having a lot of fun.
Okay, good.
We're learning a lot.
Okay. Thank you, Sue. In the meantime, if anybody that I know has any questions about Airbnb, I'm going to defer them to Sue because I don't know a lot about it because I haven't been doing it yet. I don't do it yet. Okay. So it's time. So thank you again, Sue.
Thank you.
All right. It's time to take a break and hear from our sponsors. And we'll be right back with more Let's Talk Real Estate after this on 101.5 Sports Radio Lakes Region.
Home for the holidays. I believe I've missed each and every phase. Come on and play one easy. Let's turn on every love light in the place. It's time I found myself totally surrounded in your circle.